Tracy and Brandon Conley, if they would come up and join me. They have a baby that's a beautiful dress that the baby's wearing. Is that a family heirloom?
No.
Okay. When the first child, you know, my wife has a saying. We had four children. She used to say this to the children and now to the grandbabies. She would say, man, listen carefully. She would say, I'm going to eat you up. And I became a little afraid of her when she said that. But isn't that something you want to do with children? I'm going to see if she'll let me hold her. And let me ask you a couple of questions. Is it best if she faces forward?
Yes.
How can we pray for you, Jan?
Well, we would just hope that she would grow up in the church and develop a relationship with God and learn to love Him and want to serve Him.
Okay. Anything you want to add?
No. We're just super excited for her to grow up in this church family, surrounded by you guys and our family, and we just hope that she, you know, comes to know Christ as her personal Savior and just has a great relationship with everyone here.
Yeah, good. And all my children are up there, and they're all grown and mostly married, and it was a great place for them to grow up. Maybe it was good to grow up among God's people and to have relationships that go on with them throughout their life. So this child's going to grow up among us, hopefully, and we'll see her running around and all of the things that children do, be in Sunday school and all that. How can we pray for her as a church family?
Stays humble.
But she stays humble? Okay. What else?
That she stays cute.
I don't think that'll be a problem. What about your Sunday school teacher? We've got to have a few in there. What should we pray for?
Vanessa would like her to be kind.
Sorry?
Pray that she stays kind.
Kind, okay, good. Okay, we would be good witnesses for her. You know, growing up a church family is so important. I didn't really experience that. And I've realized as my children grew up here, all of the relationships that children gain, and they see older people and who talk to them, and you know, it's a wonderful thing to experience. Let's pray that that's the case. Gracious God, I'm sorry.
I didn't know you were starting.
That's all right.
That she'll share Jesus with others, even at a young age.
All right, good.
Sorry.
Thanks. Sure. I'm gonna pray now. Again, our gracious Father, we thank you so much for this little child that I hold in my arms. Lila Grace, we pray for her that you would protect her physically and spiritually, that as she grows up in this world that is fraught with sin and sinful relationships and dangers, not only to our bodies but our souls, that you would keep her for yourself. We ask that at a young age you would make her one of your own. As she grows up and hears about Jesus here, we pray for her parents, Tracy and Brandon, that you would strengthen them by your grace in order that they might be able to give witness to her of their own faith and their desire to follow you. And we pray that she would choose, even at an early age, to follow you in discipleship, that she would find her home among the people of God, and that she would not only grow up there, but she would continue on to love and serve among us. And we entrust her to you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
It's a beautiful baby, isn't it? You know what? Paul, I heard that at 9:30 the baby puked on you. Well, just take it from a seasoned pastor. There's ways to do it in which they can. Thanks so much. All right.